video we are going to solve 620 paper 41 October-November 2020. Let's start. Question number 3. Ammonia is produced in the Haber process. The equation for the reaction is shown. In the Haber process, a temperature of 450 degrees Celsius and a pressure of 200 atmospheres are used in the presence of finely divided iron. A larger equilibrium yield of ammonia would be produced if a lower temperature and a higher pressure are used. Explain why a lower temperature and a higher pressure are not used. So the reason is because lower temperature slows down the reaction and higher pressure, it is very expensive to build up the higher pressure vessels. Lower temperature because rate of reaction is slower, higher pressure because it is expensive to maintain higher pressure vessels. Question number 2. State the role of iron in the Haber process. So students, iron acts as a catalyst in the Haber process. Question F. Ammonia is a weak base. Explain the meaning of the term base. Base is a substance which helps to accept the proton. So a substance that acts as a proton acceptor. Acid is a proton donor and base is a proton acceptor. Suggest the pH of aqueous ammonia. Because ammonia is a weak base, so its pH is around 8 to 9. So you can write pH is 8 or 9. Question number 4. Air is a mixture of gases. State the percentage of clean dry air which is oxygen. Give your answer to the nearest whole number. So students, you may know that nitrogen makes up 78% of air and oxygen makes up 21% of air. So answer is 21%. Question B. Oxygen and nitrogen are useful gases that can be obtained from air. Name the process used to separate oxygen and nitrogen from liquid air. The process which is used to separate the liquids with closer boiling point is known as fractional distillation. Okay. Question number 2. State the property of oxygen and nitrogen that allows these gases to be separated using this process. The property of both these gases which help to separate them is their boiling point. So answer is boiling point. Actually, fractional distillation is based on the boiling point. Carbon dioxide is a covalent molecule. Complete the diagram to show the electron arrangement in one molecule of carbon dioxide. State, show only the outer electrons. In this picture, we are going to complete with showing only the outer electrons. Carbon has total 6 electrons, 2, 4, 4 are in the outer shell, so we will draw 4 only. Oxygen has total 8 electrons, 2 and 6, 6 are present in the outer shell, so we will draw here 6. But we should know the structure before. Carbon is bonded with double bond with oxygen on both the sides. So it's very simple. If you see the double bond, it means carbon is sharing 2 electrons on both the sides. So these are the electrons of the carbon shown as process. And oxygen is having dots. It is bonding its electrons like this. So this is the complete picture. Question number D. The graph shows the concentration of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere over a 60-year period measured in parts per million ppm. In this picture, you are seeing the graph. Concentration is shown in the ppm of carbon dioxide gas, and this is years. And concentration is continuously increasing. The data shown in the graph is of global concern. Global concern means some global problem is associated with it. Explain why. Because the graph is showing increase in the concentration of carbon dioxide gas. Carbon dioxide gas is a greenhouse gas and it contributes to the global warming. So one mark for mentioning carbon dioxide gas concentration is increasing, second one for mentioning greenhouse gas, and third one is to contribution of the global warming. Question number E, name the process in the carbon cycle by which plants remove carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. You all know that plants take carbon dioxide by the process known as photosynthesis. Question number 5 is taken from ocean electrolysis and it is in chapter number 4 in your book. Dilute sulfuric acid is electrolyzed using the apparatus shown in the diagram. Question 1. State what is meant by the term electrolysis. Electricity lessens mean breakdown. So, it is the breakdown of an ionic compound in molten or aqueous state by the use of electricity. Question 2. Explain why inert electrodes are used. Inert means which are unreactive. So that's the reason, because they are unreactive or they do not react. Otherwise, they can react with the electrolyte. So it will be of no use. Question number 3, name the products formed at each electrode, negative and positive. So student, sulfuric acid is electrolyzed. It makes two ions by splitting hydrogen and sulfate ion. Hydrogen ions are discharged at negative electrode, yani cathode, and it forms hydrogen gas as the final product. Sulfate ions are bulky, so they don't discharge. Instead, hydroxide ions are discharged from water and they end up making oxygen gas. So, negative electrode, hydrogen gas, positive electrode, it will be oxygen gas, because they say name the product. So, please write down the names, don't write the chemical formula. Write an ionic half equation for the reaction at the negative electrode. So at cathode, as you know, hydrogen plus ions will be discharged. Hydrogen ions will discharge and get reduced. They will accept electron and make hydrogen. But hydrogen is a diatomic molecule, so we will balance the equation. 2 and 2. So now it is balanced equation. Part B, sulfuric acid is manufactured using the contact process. This manufacture involves 4 stages. Number 1. Stage 1 involves the combustion of sulfur to form sulfur dioxide. It means sulfur is burning with oxygen. Write the chemical equation for stage 1. Very simple. Sulfur burns with oxygen and makes sulfur dioxide. Question 2. The equation for stage 2 is shown. Sulfur dioxide reacts with oxygen by reversible reaction and makes sulfur trioxide. The reaction can reach equilibrium. What is meant by the term equilibrium? For 2 marks, we are going to answer. Don't forget this answer. It is very easy. Just learn it. Number 1. Rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of reverse reaction. It means the rate at which the forward reaction is going on, at the same rate, reverse reaction is going on. So it seems like dynamic equilibrium. Number 2, the concentration of reactants and products remain constant or do not change. So reactants and products, in the normal reactants get decreased and products get increased. But in reversible reaction or equilibrium reaction, reactants and products, their concentration are same, kept constant. Question 3. The energy level diagram for the forward reaction in stage 2 is shown. This is the energy and this is the progress of reaction. So sulfur dioxide reacts with oxygen and this is the product. Here is the product and here is the reactant. So if you see here that reactants are at higher level of energy as compared to the products. Products are at low level of energy, right? This is the higher level and this is the lower level. It means it starts with more and end up at low. So it releases energy outside. The energy goes outside. Exo. So the reaction is exothermic. The reaction is exothermic. Products are at low energy level. This is the reason here. Products are at low energy level and as compared to the reactants, or reactants are at high energy level. So energy is released out. Question number C. In stage 3, sulfur trioxide is converted to oleum, H2S2O7. In stage 4, oleum reacts to form sulfuric acid. State what oleum reacts with in stage 4. So oleum, in the last stage, it reacts with water to make sulfuric acid. Here is the equation. Oleum reacts with water to make sulfuric acid. So answer is water. A sample of sulfuric acid has a concentration of 0.75 mole per cubic decimeter. Calculate the concentration of sulfuric acid in gram per cubic decimeter. Very easy question. So, you know, molar mass. 1 mole of sulfuric acid has how much mass? The mass will be equal to its molar mass, or MR, or molecular mass. So, calculate the MR of sulfuric acid. 2 times 1 plus 32 plus 16 times 4, 98 grams. So if 1 mole has 98 grams, then 0.75 moles, the given value has how much grams? 98 times 0.75. So answer will be 73.5 gram per cubic decimeter. Thank you so much for watching the video, and I hope you have understood. And in the next video, I will continue the questions from question number 6 onwards. Goodbye everyone, and take care.